Hi, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Early Bird. We'll take a look at the games last night as another team is gone. Coming up. All right, guys, let's get on this. I got a few videos I want to pump out there today. And last night, sorry, folks, no chance. I'm fostering this dog and I got to watch it 24/7. I even hate leaving it out there right now for the little time I am, but she's okay. So my daughter and I are going through this thing where we're fostering this little dog for now to figure out what we can do to help this little girl out. Okay, let's take a look at the games yesterday. We had three. Let's get right to it. Here we go. Okay, the Rangers extend their series with a 5-3 win over Pittsburgh. I tell you, folks, you know, leads in this playoffs doesn't mean anything. It really doesn't. The Rangers come storming back and win this game 5-3. Washington's out. They lost in overtime 4-3. Florida finally win a playoff series. Finally. I mean, good for them. I'm happy for that franchise. It's about time something happens over there. So Florida do move on as they were supposed to, but not without a huge scare by the Washington Capitals in that series. They win the series 4-2. And final game of the night, a really good one in Dallas, as Dallas force a game 7 with a 4-2 win over Calgary there. So let's take a look. Let's start out east, and we'll start with the Rangers at Pittsburgh. Here we go. Rangers rally past Penguins in game 6, push series to limit. And the numbers, you can see, was a tight game in shots, 38-34 favoring the Rangers. Faceoffs, though, pretty one-sided in Pittsburgh's favor, 58-42%. The Rangers on the power play were the aggressor, 2-for-3. The Penguins were 0-for-3. They missed Sid right there, I could tell you. And the hits, low-hitting affair, 21 hits for the Rangers, 26 for the Penguins. And the blocks were 16 for the Rangers, 12 for the Penguins. And rounding it out in the giveaways, the Rangers had 3, the Penguins had 9. And we'll take a look at the shots period to period. The first period, 13-12 in favor of Pittsburgh. Second period, 18-13 in favor of the Rangers. And they swap 8-8 in the third. I just found in this game, folks, the Penguins kind of fizzled out. That's just how it felt for me. They fizzled out once they blew that lead. I found that they just, I don't know, were hanging on, I guess would be the word. They need Sidney Crosby in that lineup, I think, especially for game 7. There's no word on it yet, so I don't know for sure. I'm hearing around here he's playing next game, so we'll see. But they definitely need Sidney Crosby in the lineup to get through if they're going to upset the Rangers, because it is an upset if Pittsburgh win this series. So we shall see. Moving along, let's see really the game of the night as Florida was in Washington. Here we go. Panthers top Capitals in overtime in game 6, win first playoff series since 1996. And the numbers, very entertaining game. Panthers had 31 shots, the Capitals had 37. Faceoffs very even, 51%. Panthers 49, Washington. Panthers 0-for-2 in the power play, Capitals 1-for-4. And the hits, very hard-hitting affair. It was a good game. It was just a good playoff game. 50 hits for the Panthers, 51 hits for the Capitals. 19 blocks for the Panthers, 15 for the Capitals. And the giveaways, the Panthers had 8, the Capitals had 17. And the shots, first period 13-8 for Washington. Second period 14-9. For Florida, and Washington come back in the third, outshoot them 13-7. Exciting third period in this game. You know, they pull the goalie at the end, and there's a scrum in front of a net. The puck's bouncing everywhere, and it finds its way into the net. It was really a crazy end to this. Then in the overtime, 2-2, and Florida prevail. Verhaeghe the hero. And I'll tell you what, folks, Verhaeghe's going crazy. This guy's going nuts. He's just going crazy. That's one of those things that that we talk about every playoff. There's always some guy that kind of shows up and does it. And Verhaeghe, so far, this playoffs is the guy, so far. And also Kane over in Edmonton, I'll say also. Him also. But Verhaeghe's just been more exciting. You know, it's just been really special to watch. Okay, let's get out to Dallas and check out the Flames and Stars. Here we go. Stars defeat Flames in Game 6, push series to limit. And the numbers. The shots, 40-38 for Dallas. And look at the faceoffs, though. 68%, 32 for Dallas. The power play, nobody got anything. 0 for 2 for the Flames, 0 for 3 for the Stars. The hits, Flames had 23, and Dallas had 38. The blocks, 17 for Calgary, 20 for Dallas, and giveaways pretty even. They both gave the puck away, 15 for Calgary, and 16 for Dallas there. First period, the shots. The shots are 18-10 for Calgary in the first, and Dallas bounced back in the second, 17-9. And a very exciting close to this game. Dallas outshoot them in the third, 13-11. And as you see, that two-shot edge was the edge in the entire game, 40-38. So this game, you know, if recapping these just in a nutshell, I think Pittsburgh, we're feeling the heat without Crosby finally, really. I mean, I know it's a veteran team. I get it. There's guys in there with rings, yes. But you still need Crosby. You need him in that lineup. The Rangers looked like they were going down, and they fought back like they've done in this series already many times. So this is unpredictable. It's kind of like the Tampa-Toronto series, this series. I don't know who to think. And all the pressure is on the Rangers now to win Game 7. So we're going to see how that pans out. Florida, I'm happy. I'm just happy for the franchise. Really, it's about time. 1996, folks. Come on. You know, like 26 years. It's about time they win a playoff series. And the truth is, Washington played good enough to win this series, even though they lost in 6. They did. They played good enough to win this series. I mean, they just let that game slip out of their fingers, Game 5 in Washington, or Game 4 in Washington, just slipped out of their fingers. They were about to take a 3-1 series lead, slipped away. And then this overtime again, I actually thought Washington was going to win in that overtime. I thought poor Florida is going to have to win in their home ice to get this over with, but no, they scored. And Dallas were the aggressor. They were the more physical team. They were the more dominant team. And I found that Calgary kind of just sat back a little too much again. So home ice is going to play a lot. This is why teams, guys, play for the home ice so they can get these game sevens on their home ice, which now Dallas have and the Rangers have, you know, and Toronto has. I mean, these are really important. You know, in the playoffs, it's really, really important, I find, that You got to get it to that game 7 on your home ice. Unless you're really in a mess and you can't even force it to that, then, you know, you don't deserve to win the series then anyway. So, but I felt Washington put up a really good fight in that series. The only team that hasn't really put up a fight at all in this playoff was really Nashville. And the truth is, Colorado's come out pretty physical and aggressive this year so far. So we're going to see if that continues. We'll look at the first round. I'm going to look at all the hitting in the first round once the first round's out, because I like to check the hitting. I like to check what teams are doing what physically too, not just goals and not the usual cliches. I like to look what's the guys on the bench thinking before they get out on a shift. Are they worried they're going to get their head taken off? Those kind of emotions exist when you're playing hockey. So you got to have your head and eyes above, you know, looking. And you know, I feel bad. I always feel bad for teams that lose this time of the year, you know, but there's got to be 8 losers in the first round. We don't have a choice. We don't have a choice. It's just the nature of the beast, folks. We're going to see the final 8 pretty soon. We're down to the final phase of round 1. I'm definitely going to be glued to the Oilers game today. Absolutely, I'll be watching that one. The Kings, I think that's going game 7 in overtime. That was the one I said. Yeah, I think that's going to go right in overtime. Imagine being a fan of that. We've been, but imagine being at the game and you're, you know, your team is so due to do something in the playoffs like Edmonton, and here they are now in a game seven in overtime. You're probably going nuts. But anyway, that's it for this, guys. I got other videos to make since I'm home right now. I got to get back out to little Rosie. She's out in the living room probably panicking. This poor little dog's scared of everything, so I got to get out there. My cats are babysitting her, which I don't know if it's a good idea, but she's harmless and they're pretty much chill too. So, all right, folks, I'll see you in the next video.